Life on Earth as we know it would be nothing without the almighty power and serene nobility of our oceans. As they say, the sea is a cruel mistress, and since the dawn of civilization, we have relied on her endless bounty to give life and bear witness to the rise and fall of countless empires, always within the mortal reminder that the power of the seven seas is both awesome and incomprehensible to humanity. But despite the massive importance that the oceans have played on our planet, in this hypothetical situation, we're going to be pulling the plug on the ocean bed and seeing what our planet would be like without the deep blue sea. Wait, what? I didn't agree to this. Hello internet, what's going on? And once again, welcome back to the most inquisitive channel on YouTube, Life's Biggest Questions. As per usual, I'll be your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch, as today we curiously ask the question, what if we drained the oceans? Roll the clip. Curious amongst you, that clip was from 2018's The Meg, because, come on, The Meg is completely ridiculous, and this is a ridiculous hypothetical scenario about the bottom of the oceans. And it's also important to note that if we did drain the deep blue sea, that we better damn well be prepared to face some ticked off giant squid that wondered where the hell all of his ocean just went. Oh, and also, probably a megalodon, yeah, and Cthulhu. More than likely. Anyway, let's try not to think about all of the strange alien nasties that are lurking down on the deepest, dankest, darkest ocean bed. Because first we have to figure out how we'd even drain the oceans in the first place. And more importantly, where the hell are we going to put all of this water? Now, obviously, this is going to take quite a bit of hypothetical MacGyvering, but fear not, because luckily for us, we have the strange and wonderful power of the human brain. First and foremost, it's important to note that around 97% of all of the Earth's water resides within our oceans, and more than 70% of the surface of our planet is covered in the deep blue sea. In fact, in 2010, a group of scientists and researchers used satellite measurements to estimate the volume of our oceans, and it turned out to be a massive 0.3 billion cubic miles, or 1.332 billion cubic kilometers for the metric system users amongst us. If you can't tell already, that's a hell of a lot of water for us to drain, and it quickly becomes apparent that this isn't exactly the same stroll in the park as draining a bathtub. Rubber duckies aside, it's also important for us to specify the means in which we're draining the oceans. And so in this hypothetical situation, we'll go out on a limb and say that suddenly, out of nowhere, a plug hole the size of, I don't know, a London double-decker bus emerges at the bottom of Challenger Deep, the deepest point in the Mariana Trench, which just so happens to be the deepest known point in the entirety of the seven seas. Also, don't worry about where the water's going. Let's just say it's dropped into the void of space. Yeah. That works, right? You may also think, uh-oh, that's really bad. We just sprung a leak and this thing is going to be over in the snap of an instant, the planet destroyed, civilization in ruins, humanity wiped off the map forever. But actually, even with a plug hole of that size, it would be nothing in comparison to the unimaginable magnitude of our oceans. The amount of ocean coverage on our planet is absolutely huge, and even going at incredible speeds, at a massive rate of drainage, the water level of our planet would drop by less than a centimeter per day. In fact, if our planet did spring a leak, it would actually take hundreds of thousands of years for our oceans to drain, which strangely is kind of a comforting thought, isn't it? But that's no fun at all. So let's say that particular double-decker bus-sized drain started popping up in dozens of different regions of the ocean bed. That'd speed things up a bit, right? Well, actually, yes. Yes, it would. But still, in comparison to the absolutely mammoth volume of our oceans, it would still take a couple of thousand years to drain. And there wouldn't even be any cool apocalyptic whirlpools until at least several hundred years into the draining process, just like how a bathtub doesn't start swirling until more than half of the water has been emptied. Nevertheless, as the ocean bed became ever expanding and that 1.3 billion cubic kilometers of ocean water surged through the planetary plug holes, the landscape of our planet would gradually turn into an oasis of Earth. After just a 50 meter drop in the level of our oceans, the results would be earth shattering, or, well, earth revealing? Yeah, I guess. At a drop of 50 meters, islands both small and large, such as the UK, New Guinea, Java, Borneo, and the islands of Sri Lanka, would become completely connected to their neighbors. The Netherlands of Europe, a country that has been at the beck and call of the sea for thousands of years in their attempt to hold it back, would finally be able to gasp their head above water, finally treading on the low sea level surface that has been covered throughout the course of their civilization. At 100 meters drained, things get ever more interesting when a huge new island off the coast of Nova Scotia would be exposed, the former site of the Grand Banks of Newfoundland, a group of previously underwater plateaus that, whilst they were underwater, were considered one of the richest fishing grounds in the world. All those fish, though, yeah, they just got sucked down a plug hole. Probably. As the water levels continued to fall, many inland bodies of water, such as the Black Sea, would cease shrinking and remain vastly unchanged by the drainage of the oceans. This is because many inland bodies of water would cease to be connected to the ocean, and some of their basins would cut off from the rest of the drainage. For the vast majority of these bodies of water, they would eventually become landlocked and just stop draining. So yeah, it's not all doom and gloom. Humanity would still have a water source. Kind of. The waters are surging now, though, and at 200 meters, entire new islands would begin to emerge across the Pacific and the majority of the Asian coast. Indonesia, for one, would become a great big blob, all of its islands becoming one mass. At 500 meters, Japan would become connected to Russia via the Korean Peninsula, which is an insane thought in itself, isn't it? With 1 kilometer of our ocean levels gone, New Zealand would suddenly become absolutely huge. It's kind of good news for the Arctic, though, kind of, and at 1 kilometer, its ocean would be cut off from the rest of the drainage and become isolated for all time, albeit much, much smaller. Things also get really, really weird when we reach 3 kilometers worth of drained ocean depth, and suddenly the vast majority of those underwater mid-ocean ridges would become, well, mountain ranges towering high above the new earth that they surrounded. Completely new rugged land would become accessible that before was the only privilege of subterranean planet Earth. For the most part, we would pretty much have undeterred access to every shipwreck throughout the course of our civilization's history. Currently, it's estimated that anywhere up to 3 million undiscovered shipwrecks lie at the bottom of the ocean bed, so that's a lot of gold to potentially plunder. But the biggest question is, would there be anyone left alive to find it? Now, there is no denying that draining the oceans would undeniably result in the complete collapse of our ecosystem and thus likely the extermination of our species. However, it actually isn't all doom and gloom, because humanity may well be in for a slight chance of survival with this one. Remember those inland oceans I mentioned previously? Well, yeah, they could potentially still harbor and support life, albeit life that has pretty much already been brought close to extinction. If a small reduced population could survive close to places such as the Great Lakes of North America, albeit a much smaller version, then there's a chance that pockets of survivors could thrive long enough to discover just exactly what the oceans had left behind. Who knows, given enough time, an entirely new civilization could emerge from the lakes, capable of harnessing water during the most impossible of circumstances. Well, given enough time, the Mariana Trench would have been drained completely, potentially waiting for this brave new civilization to plummet its rocky depths and climb on down into the abyss to see what all the fuss was about. They'd be free to roam and explore, perhaps giving light to the one question that our species has always strived to answer. What lies at the bottom of the ocean? Yeah, it's probably Cthulhu, isn't it? Well, there we have it, our long and short answer to the question. What if we drain the oceans? Most of us would die, there'd be a few survivors, civilization would be rebuilt, and we'd have to fight giant squid monsters for buried treasure. Well, when you put it like that, sign me up. What do you guys think? Let us know your thoughts down in the comment section below, as well as any interesting insights you have to offer. Before we depart from today's video, though, let's first take a quick look at some of your more creative comments from over the past few days. Stephen Matthews says, short answer, we die. Long answer, we die. My answer, I am making a meme out of this. Hey, buddy, hold on a minute there. That's my line. Well, I can't blame you for the ingenuity. Good job, Stephen Matthews. Good job. Well, on that note, unfortunately, that's all we've got time for in today's video. Cheers for sticking around all the way until the end. If you were a fan of this video, or just Life's Biggest Questions in particular, then please be a dear and hit that thumbs up button, as well as that subscribe bell, and I'll be seeing you in the next one. As per usual, I've been your disembodied floating voice, Jack Finch. You've been watching Life's Biggest Questions. Until next time, you take it easy.